Good afternoon. Okay, I'm back. It's cured up and we are ready to move on to the other side. So, let me see where we're at visually. That'll work. Okay. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take the flashing off now. No big deal. See how it doesn't stick? And I think I'm gonna keep this flashing. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is I want to get tin foil. I'm going to put this off to the side right now. Worry about this later. Take that apart and take all the tape off of it. What I really need. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put tin foil right up against this edge and then wrap it over the side of this. So this way, we're not dealing with any you know what, where's my rasp? Let's do this real quick. Good rasp. This is a rasp, in case you're wondering. It's a Stanley rasp. We don't want to be too hard on this. We're just trying to take down any sharp edges because easier with the tin foil. Okay. Rasp are wonderful things. Air compressing. That don't matter because this stuff here clings to itself. So even if I have a little bit of it on here, it's not going to hurt it because we're going to use it anyway. All right, so. Time for tin foil. And I'm not using the thick tin foil, I'm just using the thin stuff. Just stick with small sheets. I'm going to go into this area here. Small pieces. Come on, stay still, damn it. This thing's because of the weight. So much weight, and this thing's a little bit downhill. Why I'm doing this is to create a little bit of a barrier. See, I folded it over on this side so the nothing will stick to it. We don't want these two parts sticking together on us. Perfect. Didn't look like it could be perfect, but it is. And remember, even if it's rippled like this and it doesn't match to the perfect smoothness of this side, these get bolted together. So you really squeeze it together tight, it won't move. It doesn't have to be that flush. This is an outer shell, not an inner shell. The inside shell, which is the silicone, is the one that has to be accurate. All right, time to sit because now it's getting down low. How low can I go? Damn it, stay still. Little piece right in there. There we go. Pain in the ass. I wish it would stay still. Make these large pieces because now this side's going to suck. Well, maybe not. If I can turn it to this point. No, it's going to, I'll have to wedge something underneath of this thing. Definitely going to have to wedge something underneath. What do I have that I can fit under this? Fix that. One last piece. Maybe some tape. Now I gotta break out the paste wax again. What am I thinking? It only matters what I do. Thank you. All right, paste wax again. Did I take it back already? I think I did. Yeah, I did. I put it away like I'm supposed to. Gotta get the screwdriver again. Yes, I'm gonna get this mold completely hard cased today. Let the fun begin. I need this for the paste wax. Once I get the surface all done. So what I'm doing here, I'm paste waxing the tin foil, that's all. Come on, stay still. Won't fall off anymore. Get in there real good, just into the seam real good, because if there's any of that plastic showing through, that could be a disaster. That could be a lock on me. And we don't want no locks. There. Screw it. I'll make sure that I don't get locked in there. going over the over, just over top of the edge on both sides. Okay, we're there. Now that thing's shot. Okay, put the paste wax back, and we are ready to start mixing up some plasti. Only this time, wear gloves, Johnny boy. Wear gloves. I'm going to keep them right there. Put some gloves on. I got plastic on my hands and it's a pain in the ass to get off. And I got a tear in my pants over here. Oh well. I've seen me before, I don't care. I'm definitely not a shy guy. By far. And don't care what people think or say. So you walk a mile in these shoes. You never understand. And that goes for all of us. Nobody knows what it's like to be you. So I got that plastic on my hands. It's gonna come off. I just have to take it off slowly but surely. I ain't putting no more shit on me though, that's for sure. Okay, so I've got my new buckets over there. We're pretty much making a we'll keep that tool there. Yeah, baby. Okay. So the first part, we need to add, that's what I'll do. I just figured out a way to keep this thing from moving around while I'm, what did I figure it was going to be? We're doing 24 ounces, so that's 12 ounces I got to do of this stuff. The new bucket. That is a problem where you have to constantly use new buckets. I've got my other mixing I bought some more of those mixing containers so I can that. Now we got to put the plastic paste in there. That over there. Move this over here. Let's move this over here. And let's dig out a new stick. I bought 10 packs. I got two 10 packs. of the sticks. Two 10 packs of sticks. I'll just leave them in here. Jesus, just when I thought I had plenty of goddamn room, and I don't have a lot of room. It's terrible. Alright, first thing I gotta do is open this container. I still got a little bit of plasti paste in the other bucket from the other mold that I made a while back. Come on. Yeah, that stuff's as hard as a rock now, man. Now we're going to make 24 ounces of this. Push it down, baby. Push it down. That's where we're at. We're right there. rubber mallet. Push that over there. Now let's mix. Well, this time, we're going to make sure we get it all out of the bucket first before I trowel around. Supposed to read instructions every once in a while, you know what I mean? So while I was on between coats, I read the instructions. You got to make sure you get all the stuff out of the bucket when you first apply this, when you first mix this up, because it heats up. And if you can spread it out, it slows the curing time just a little bit. You get it all out of the bucket. Alright, started to heat up already. So I need to get this pushed up against there. I want you guys to be able to see what I'm doing. I want it really thick on this wall. Get over on this side. Gravity's working against me right now because the stuff is still pasty or still It's not real pasty, it's more liquidy right now. Around this. The next batch will take care of
see you later.
Oh, I love you. Why don't you come check it out real quick?
Man, that smells awful.
Yeah, it's not fun.
Oh, God. Ew.
Yeah, this is not fun.
No.
Okay. So, getting very sticky now. See, it's not cooperating like it was. But there's nothing left in here, so I'm not worried about it. Okay, so the next batch I do. I'm gonna salvage this stick. Put a new set of gloves on. Put this bucket over there with that bucket. Now we just thicken the walls, we thicken this area here more. And we fill in the little bit of details that's over here on this side that I still have to do. Okay, so we don't have to wait for anything. I do want to get rid of these gloves. There we go, turn them inside out, boom, right in the trash. All right. Two new sets of gloves. I get my gloves at Harbor Freight. I still think that's the best store on the planet. The best store anywhere, everywhere. That's going to be my new rule. Anytime I start messing with these chemicals and stuff, I'm definitely wearing gloves. Even with the naphtha. I'm going to get I'm going to steer clear of doing naphtha. I think at one point I'm going to try to start going into using a butane torch. I think the best one to use, believe it or not, is actually a cigar torch. You know, the kind you light your cigar with. Well, I'm going to stop at a cigar shop and pick up one of those torches because that is perfect when it comes to melting the very outer surface, just like the naphtha does for smoothing out. So that's what I plan on doing. There's my little stick. Can't use that stick though. I can use it for mixing. I can't use it to scoop it out. I need a fresh stick for that. You do go through some material when you're doing this stuff. You really do. You know, so just remember that going forward. Anything to be driving me crazy. All right, so now we're going to go with 16 ounces and 8 ounces of the other stuff and a fresh new bucket. But then we're done. The hard shell. I know my mixes have been perfect because the stuff's hardening up perfectly. It looks the right color. The color's not too dark. Usually if you have too much of the other stuff in there, it'll get darker. At first I thought, man, that looks awful dark. And then it lightened up quite significantly. The plasti paste. Shove this down in there, see how much we got. I'm sorry, we're going 12 ounces. Right? Yeah, 12 ounces. Not what I did? Or was it 16? Come on, get off of there. It's not like I added any hardener yet. Yeah, we'll go 16. It's gonna hurt. Yeah, it was 16 ounces because I'm adding 8 ounces of the, it was 16. 16 is what we came up with. But we're done with the plastic paste now. So that'll get put away. Let me get a fresh bucket. I might be able to salvage the Wow, got that out in one swap, one swoop. Dig into the next can because this one's done. And I gotta punch a hole in it. Do the same thing I did to the other one. Get out of there. Jesus Christ. There we go. Ouchie. Now, 16 ounces. No, 8 ounces. 8 ounces. Ooh, I didn't shake this. Hold on, sucker. Hold on. Gotta shake this up real good. There we go. Shook up well. That's about right. another stick. Let's get mixing. This is the last batch. And then we got to demold. I'm gonna open up my back door because this stuff throws off a lot of noxious gas. So, don't mind the heat so much. I just gotta have the circulation in here. There we go. All right, let's get this thing pinned so I can work on it with no problems. This is awkward. I need something, maybe a brush. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a brush on here. Yeah, that's a lot easier. I know I'm blocking your view. Sorry, guys. I got myself. I'm totally focused here because I'm running out of pot life time on this. I got to make sure I thicken up the areas that need thickening up. Damn it, what is this? I think what it is the tinfoil is trying to come off over here. That's not good, but it's not a disaster. I just hope this area isn't a problem. We'll find out soon enough. Just feels too thin. Okay. That bucket's done. Okay, now I just gotta let it harden up. And we are finished. And then what the next step is to demold it. And that shouldn't take that long. It shouldn't take long at all. And we drill holes through it. You know, key places, boom, 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 you know. We're going to put screws with wing nuts on them. Oh, yeah. So that's it, man. Screws with wing nuts. Just going extra cautious on this. Because of the fact that that's thick enough there. And this is thick right up in here, so we're good. So we just let this cure up a little bit. And we'll be ready for the next part of this adventure. All right, guys. See you on the next video. And we should have a really nice Custom Corpses FB78. FB stands for flashback. So, looking forward to this. All right, guys, see you in a little while. Maybe it might have to wait till tomorrow. I want to make sure it's cured up really good. Yeah, I'll wait till tomorrow before I pry this open. So peace, everybody. See you on the next video. We'll pry this sucker open, and then we'll see what we see, won't we?